Good morning and welcome to SSIT's Daily News Trends. The Limpopo police have launched a manhunt for 7 suspects involved in kidnapping of 4 children. Limpopo police have launched a manhunt against 7 heavily armed suspected kidnappers who kidnapped 4 children on the outskirts of Polokwane. The driver of the scholar transport was left unharmed at the scene along the R37 near the N1 bypass. The children aged 11, 13 and 15 from the suburb Navana were being taken to school at Dalmada when a group of armed men travelling in 2 vehicles, a white Kia Seranto and a black Mercedes-Benz, blocked them, forced the children off from the vehicle while shooting randomly. Police says the victim's cell phones were later found dumped at Flora Park. Police spokesperson Mutlafilo Mujabilo says the motive for the incident is still unknown, but investigations are continuing. Online dating scam. 8 con suspects appear in court. 8 foreign nationals arrested in Cape Town in connection with a multi-million dollar online dating scam have appeared in the Cape Town Magistrate's Court. The crimes are alleged to have taken place in the US, where women were scammed out of their savings, pensions, or inheritance. The men were arrested on Tuesday and are now facing extradition to the US. They were arrested in Parklands and Tableview areas after a multidisciplinary operation that included the Hawks, Crime Intelligence, and Interpol. A grade 10 pupil is overjoyed after getting her COVID-19 vaccine. A grade 10 pupil at Sonke High School took the initiative to get vaccinated after Health Minister Joe Phahla announced last week that the vaccine will be available for children between the age of 12 and 17 from Wednesday. Cleshai Riley, 16, went for her dose of the Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine at Clainville Recreation Hall shortly before noon on Wednesday and only waited in the line for about 10 minutes to get her jab. Cliche said she feels that getting vaccinated protects both the individual and those around them. Another minibus taxi set alight in Johannesburg. Another minibus taxi has been set alight in Johannesburg. This is after 4 minibus taxis were torched and 6 others damaged over the weekend. Earlier today, a taxi was left burning at the Wanderers taxi rank in the Johannesburg CBD. Police say that no one was hurt. The incident is expected to be linked to ongoing taxi violence in the province between the Witwatersrand African Taxi Association and the Nasefield Dube West Association. The associations both operate between Johannesburg and Soweto and have been feuding over routes for years. Gauteng Transport MEC Jacob Mamabulo earlier obtained an order interdicting both groups from any violence. The situation is tense in Eswatini as pro-democracy groups intensify the protest. The situation remains tense in the Kingdom of Eswatini as pro-democracy groups intensify their protest and police are using force to square the situation. Videos of police shooting at citizens are making rounds on social media platforms. The citizens have been protesting, calling for democratic reforms and also the release of the 2 arrested members of parliament. The 2 MPs are Mduduzi Bacete Mabuza and Mthandeni Dube, who were arrested and charged with terrorism in July. That's it for your daily trends today, and thank you for choosing SSIT.